Welcome, class 9, in our virtual learning method. So in last video I have completed different topics. So in today's topic we will be discussing that political history and administration of Chandragupta Maurya and Asoka. This is just the topic, but basically I'll be discussing regarding Chandragupta Maurya. So who was Chandragupta Maurya? This is like the main thing we need to understand regarding the Mauryan Empire. So 340 BCE to 298 BCE, Chandragupta that is the dateline of Chandragupta Maurya. He was a person who unified India into first Hindu-centric empire. So what does this Hindu-centric empire means? Previously, when we were like India was dominated by Mughals, previously India was dominated with Mughals. So he was the first person to make like the entire India as an Hindu-centric empire, and he ruled India from 322 to 298 BC. And Chandragupta Maurya won battles to keep his kingdoms. So he fought war with many other kingdoms to keep his kingdom safe, and he also accepted Jainism in later years. He accepted Jainism in later years and gave up his throne to his son Bindusara, and fast to death. This is just a biography. We just say a biography of Chandragupta Maurya. So in this image is about Chandragupta Maurya. So I guess you have heard about Asoka, the great king. He was the grandson. Asoka was the grandson of Chandragupta Maurya, ruled India from 269 to 232 BCE. And Asoka was one of the greatest king, and he fought many battles. And the famous battle is Kalinga War, where from this war he changed his perspective, expanded the empire and converted into Buddhism and reject violence. So Chandragupta Maurya followed Jainism, whereas his grandson followed Buddhism and rejected violence and spreads peaceful living throughout his empire. He was like changed after the Kalinga War. Asoka was changed into a better person. So that better person rejected violence and talked about peaceful living. So now let's go to the third slide. So how this Mauryan Empire emerged? We need to understand how this Mauryan Empire evolved. When Alexander came into India, ruling dynasty of Magadha was Nandas. Ruling dynasty of Magadha was, we can call it as Nandas, because the thing is that this Nanda dynasty was quite not like very not good, but it was like very not good, and it was very cruel in his teachings. So Nanda dynasty was formed by Mahapadmananda. Who formed Nanda dynasty? Nanda dynasty was formed by Mahapadmananda and Dhananand can be considered as the last ruler of Nanda dynasty. So what kind of king was this Dhananand? Dhananand was wicked and cruel and unpopular among his people. He was wicked, cruel and unpopular among his people. So Dhananand, one day, what happened means Dhananand, insulted Chanakya. At the beginning of the videos, from subsequent earlier videos, I have talked about who was Chanakya. Chanakya can be considered as Kautilya and the writer of Arthashastra, the book Arthashastra, where we can get a detailed account of how a country should be run, how a politics should be done, what are the rules and regulations that a kings and a ministers to be followed while administrating a state. So, Dhananand insulted Chanakya in his court. This made Chanakya determined to free the people from the country from this wicked ruler. So one day, this is just a story. This is story of how Chanakya met Chandragupta Maurya. So one day when he was passing, he saw a little boy playing the role of the king with his village friends. At that time, Chanakya saw promise in boy and took the boy in the city of Taxila, where that boy was trained in all forms to make fit for the greater task. To fit for a greater task is to later on to challenge this Dhananand and throw away with the Nanda dynasty. So then, that boy, here we are talking about this young boy we are talking about Chandragupta Maurya. Chandragupta Maurya became the founder of Mauryan Empire. Thus we can say Mauryan Empire has established. So in order to understand more things, you can read the page number, like read the biography of Chandragupta Maurya from page number 152, what were his parents' name, like so on and so forth. He was this Chandragupta Maurya from a Kshatriya clan. You can get it in that page number H152. So now let's talk about Chandragupta Maurya. So after Chandragupta Maurya laid the foundation of Mauryan Empire, he had to face successor of Alexander, that is Seleucus. So we already know who was Alexander the Great king and how he met King Porus, so on and so forth. So when Chandragupta Maurya dethroned Dhananand and Chandragupta Maurya became a sole king of Mauryan Empire, he had to face Alexander's successor, Seleucus Nicator. Successor was Seleucus Nicator, and he was like, what happened was, Seleucus Nicator was from a Greek. He was from Greek like Alexander. He came to Indus in 303 BC, but there was no accordance of any no accord of any conflict between CGM stands for Chandragupta Maurya and S stands for Seleucus Nicator. So we can see that there will be face off between Chandragupta many kings, but in India, when Seleucus Nicator came to India, there was no confrontation between Seleucus Nicator as well as Chandragupta. This picture, it's like a stone carved out of stone, Seleucus Nicator. That original picture is not there, but this picture can make you can make out how the Seleucus Nicator was like in a person. So now, what happened means, after the successor of Alexander met Chandragupta Maurya, Seleucus made a peace accord with Mauryan Empire and gave the territories of Herat, Khandar, and Kabul in Afghanistan. This is there in Afghanistan. So what happened was, Seleucus gave Herat, Khandar, and Kabul in Afghanistan. So in that terms only, that Chandragupta Maurya was very happy, and in return he gave 800 war elephants to Seleucus Nicator. Furthermore, there was a matrimonial alliance was established between Seleucus and Chandragupta Maurya, because Seleucus gave his daughter Helena to Chandragupta Maurya. Apart from that, Seleucus sent ambassador named Megathens to Chandragupta Maurya's court, who wrote book on the conditions of the country at that period of time. And I know that in early videos I have talked about Megathens. Kindly recapitulate it. So in the next slide I will show you. The thing is, like, Herat is here, Afghanistan is here, and Khandar province is here. So it was why I'm showing this one is that Seleucus came to India, not India, he came to Indus. So at that period of time, India was not partitioned, and the whole India Pakistan was one. Whole India and Pakistan was one country. So that Afghanistan, Kabul and Khandar, Herat, it was located in that period, that area. So Chandragupta Maurya's administration, let's talk about his administration in a little bit. So he evolved uniform and efficient system. Who evolved? Chandragupta Maurya evolved uniform means one, and efficient means very good. Uniform means one, and efficient means good. One means all should follow, all should follow one rule. So that administration was improved by his grandson. And again, that the administration led down by the Chandragupta Maurya was improved by grandson, who was grandson Ashoka. So now the three generation, let's talk about three generation. It's just a short note about three kings of Mauryan Empire, that is Chandragupta Maurya, Bindusar and Ashoka. So it was Chandragupta Maurya, under the guidance of Chanakya, who laid the foundation of an elaborate system of administration. Chanakya wrote a book, Arthashastra, in which he describes the principles of politics and the art of administration. Chandragupta's son Bindusara retained the same system, and Ashoka made some minor changes necessitated by the change of heart after the Kalinga War. Mauryan administration had two main divisions, civil administration and as well as military administration. Now, civil means for people, and military means in army that will lead to battles, war, etc. Okay, this is just a short note regarding the three generations, regarding three generation. So coming to the next slide, let's talk about significance of Chandragupta Maurya in history. Why Chandragupta Maurya is very important in history is that he freed India, the Indian nation, from foreign domination. At that period of foreign domination was Mughals. So created all India Empire, all unified out the Greek from India, Indian soil, by great diplomacy and wisdom, by maintaining a friendly relation with them. This means that India were sent to Greek, and Greek people were came to India with the art of diplomacy. He maintained a friendly relation with them. Now let's coming to the next slide, that is success of Chandragupta Maurya. How he was succeeded, let's understand how Chandragupta Maurya succeeded. Diplomacy of Chanakya helped him to usurp the power of Nanda dynasty. Chandragupta Maurya to dethrone Nanda with his brains. So this was one of the first important success. Growing decision among Greek governors of Alexander in India, like they were like very much interested, but also Chandragupta Maurya took participate in different kind of things with diplomacy, etc. revolt in Greek satrapies who disliked Alexander's policy for the conquest. So Alexander was ruling India, but the people was very much not people disliked Alexander's policies of conquest, and people was too tired. Alexander's army was too tired to go and go every time in war. So they revolted back to Alexander, and that was also beneficial for Chandragupta Maurya. Assassination of Philip, an important satrapy in India, that was also the other success. And unpopularity of Dhanananda among his people. I have already said that Dhanananda was like a wicked person. Dhanananda was wicked and not good, good with these people. Not good with these people. So, now, we have already discussed about Chandragupta Maurya, Megathins also we have, Chanakya's Arthashastras. Now we will be dealing with Asoka's and Asoka's administration. Edicts of Asoka is already done. So we will be discussing these two things in next video. Okay, now this is the last thing that I will be discussing in today's class. So thank you, and complete your notes, and I guess that everyone have their notes in their hand, and try to complete your exercises parallelly. So from the question, long structured question as well as short structured question, long as well as short question and answer, long question and answer. Okay, this much for today. Take care and stay safe.